absolutely just senseless. See, that's where you get to the senselessness of the whole situation.
Family members and Milwaukee police are searching for answers in the shooting of a star basketball player who has now died of his injuries. Good evening. I'm Kathy Michaelby.
And I'm Terry Sater. Toya has the night off. Lavelle Felton was home on a break from his basketball career in Germany when he was shot early Wednesday.
12 News reporter Nick Bohr is live downtown. Nick, do police have any leads?
Well, Kathy, they do. They're not elaborating on them, saying they don't want to tip off any of the potential suspects as they continue their search. But Felton's family, as you heard, they're certainly stunned and grief-stricken, calling his murder senseless. Family members and friends say this picture of Lavelle Felton says it all. He was about family and staying close, even when his basketball career took him away from them.
He went overseas and pursued his dream, he was living his dream over there.
Was he having fun?
Yes, he was having a good time.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. He just missed his family, of course, when he was over there. But he was having a good time.
The Milwaukee Madison High School star was shot early Wednesday at a gas station near 35th and Lloyd. He died late last night. Police tell 12 News the motive is still under investigation. Felton's stepfather calls his death absolutely senseless.
There was no confrontation with the other parties, but they started shooting, and somebody snuck up on the car and shot him at close range. Just, you know, one of those hate things, you know? We don't like you because you drive an old school car with big rims on it. You in our neighborhood. What are you doing over here?
So instead of saying goodbye to Lavelle as he headed back to Germany tomorrow as planned, the family is planning his funeral.
To have him leave like that is just a surreal thing. You know, it's just, I keep using that word surreal, but that's how it is. That's the only way I can describe it is it's not real.
And again, so far, no arrests have been made. Anyone with information is, of course, asked to call Milwaukee Police, 935-7360. Live downtown, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
Thank you, Nick.